Hey, what's up guys? It's Steph here. I'm the Secret Slob, and today I want to talk about overwhelm. So for years I struggled with overwhelm and disorganization, and I had a crazy, messy, slobby house. Over the past few years, I've been working to get it together, get more organized, get my house clean, just generally have a more calm mental state and just have my act together. But sometimes, without any warning, that feeling of complete overwhelm and helplessness comes back. Maybe it's because you're taking care of little kids or other family members or sick family members, or you're sick yourself, you know, or even just you have too much on your plate because you've said yes a few too many times. We've all been there, and now you kind of have to face the music. So today I want to talk about overwhelm and where to start when you are just buried in things to do and clutter and overwhelm and disorganization, and on top of all that, you're taking care of other people and yourself. So these are my five things that I go back to whenever that happens to me, whenever I'm in survival mode. Sometimes it's even just one day of your week. For me, I have to go into survival mode on Tuesday because I pretty much spend the entire day in my vehicle driving my children to different things, and we have milliseconds between activities. I don't love it, but it's the way Tuesday has worked out for us, and that's when I have to be ready and be prepared. So here they are, five things that are going to help you get started when you feel overwhelmed and just completely buried in things to do. Number one, you've probably heard this before somewhere in your life, whether it's from me or on an airplane, always put on your own oxygen mask first. If you are tired and run down and exhausted and you haven't cared for yourself, how on earth are you going to care for the people and the things around you? So I know sometimes it's hard when we have little kids. We want to put them as a number one priority. But if we haven't taken care of ourselves, we are often in no shape to take care of our kids and the people around us and our homes and our lives. So my number one rule for everyone, but especially moms, is take care of yourself first. Do your best to fuel your body with healthy foods that you know will serve you. Drink your water, and the most important thing is get a good night's sleep. Now I know if you have a little baby, you're thinking, how am I supposed to sleep? My baby keeps me up all night. I hear ya. This is my trick for that, and it's just temporary. You don't have to do it the rest of your life, but for in this time, in survival time, this is gonna help you so much. I go to bed at 8 p.m. when my kids don't sleep through the night. 8 p.m. And I stay in bed till 7 a.m. And regardless of how many times my kids get up in the night, somewhere in there, I'm usually able to squeak out 6 to 7 hours of sleep. And with that amount of sleep, I am better able to function the next day, serve my kids, and set myself up for a better day. So do everything you can to get to bed early. You might have to sacrifice a little bit of me time or time with your husband or your spouse for now, but like I say, it's temporary, and if you have a good sleep, everything else in your life is going to be a lot smoother. So number two, of course we have to talk about cleaning because this is a cleaning channel, and really just keeping your house in order can just bring you so much more peace on the inside. So I always talk about my morning routine, my evening routine, how I get all my detailed cleaning done. I can link to a more in-depth video below, but for now, when you're in survival mode, I want you to just stick to the basics. Things that absolutely must get done every day. So every day you're gonna eat, you probably have dishes. So your dishes routine has to stay. We have to wear clothes every day and we want them to be clean, so laundry has to get done. So we have dishes and we have laundry. The last thing, and again, it goes back to rule number one, is taking care of yourself. I want you to really focus on getting dressed first thing in the morning, having a shower, brushing your hair, you know, putting on makeup if you want. Doesn't have to take forever. Just making sure you're clean and you're in clean, comfortable clothes. You're ready for the day. This will just set everything else up to be so much easier. So that's it. Dishes, getting yourself dressed, and doing your laundry, one small load every single day. If you are now currently getting those three things done and not feeling overwhelmed and exhausted by them, add one more thing. Add a 5-minute task or a 2-minute hotspot. Again, I'll link to all those extra things you can add below, but for now, in survival mode, when you're overwhelmed, if you've gotten those three things done today, that's a big check mark. You are done. The third thing that has been a total game changer for me, once I became a mom, my brain was just filled with things to remember. And so now I really try to write it all down. I write down groceries I need to get. I make sure to keep all of my appointments in my Google Calendar, like to the point where if someone says, hey, let's go for a walk tomorrow, I put it in the calendar. It's just one less thing to keep in my mind. So start trying to get into the habit of really writing things down. You don't need a fancy planner or a fancy notebook, just a plain old piece of paper and say, you know, this is my day. These are things I have to remember. Getting your list of things to do out of your brain and onto a piece of paper will change everything. So number four, and it's what the Girl Guides and Boy Scouts always say, be prepared. If you know there is a time of crazy busyness coming, maybe you're having a baby in a couple months, or you know relatives are coming to stay, or for me, you know it's Monday and tomorrow's Tuesday, my crazy day, be prepared. Do everything you can to make that time or that day in your life as easy as possible. Get meals prepared ahead of time, buy them from the store so they're just pop in the oven, ready to go, plan to go out for dinner that night, everything you can to just make that day go so much easier. In addition to that, try and set your items out that you need for that next day. If you need sports bags for your kids' sports, set them out the night before. If you need lunches packed, do it the day before. Everything you can do to make that crazy day or that crazy time easier, do it when you do have extra time. The last thing, number five, and I think probably the second most important thing after taking care of yourself, is know when you've had enough and when to ask for help. Help can come in so many forms. Maybe you don't live near family so they can't come over, but you probably have a good friend you can reach out to and ask for a favor. You can order food for delivery. Hey, that's a form of help. Hire someone to clean your house if it's stressing you out. You know, if you're just completely overwhelmed, it's just not something that you need on your plate right now. You can get back into your routines later. So those are my five tips for helping get you started when you feel like you're just buried in things to do and you're in total survival mode. I hope it helps you, but most importantly, I hope you're kind to yourself and you realize that you're doing your best with the energy you have, and that is good enough. It's all about progress, not perfection. It's impossible to be perfect, even when you have all the energy and the tools in the world. If you're feeling down, you're feeling overwhelmed, get one little thing done, or hey, just go have a nap. Sleep is everything. I will talk to you very soon. Bye.